pregame.com.
Denver at San Diego, huge clash in the AFC West. San Diego opened a 7-point favorite, total 44.5. Still 7, but there are some 6.5s out there. Sharp money taking Denver. Totals dropped to 42. No surprise, not many bettors going over with Tim Tebow at quarterback. This one's my best bet, and I'm going to tell you, I usually come real prepared with my notes. You see, they're different colors. I'm very thorough. For this one, it was this easy. This is my notes right here. Here you go. This is my notes.
Put it up a little bit higher, folks.
Here's my notes.
No, right in front of your face.
This
is
all you need. All you got to look at is Tim Tebow. Nothing else. Bottom line, the name alone brings you so much betting value because of all the negativity you hear throughout the week. You hear ex-players, you hear ex-coaches, you hear commentators, writers, journalists, everybody, sports radio saying how bad of a quarterback he is. And the only thing that does is influence the line. And the odds makers have no problem discounting Denver because nobody's betting them except me. I love betting Denver right now because you're getting more points than you should be getting. I'm going to tell you this, bottom line, last year in San Diego, when Denver was 4-12, not this year where they're battling for the division, last year when they were 4-12, they were getting only 8.5 at San Diego. Now you're giving me 7 based on what? What has San Diego done to justify being a 7-point favorite? And this is coming from someone who's as unbiased as anyone because I have a future bet on San Diego. So if anything, I want them to be the real deal. I want them to, you know, be justified to lay 7 points in a game like this. But I can't. I've given up on them. There's no reason to expect they're going to be that team who in previous years has had a great second half. They've rushed for 100 yards once in the last 5 games. How are they going to do anything against this Denver defense? And as bad as people say Tim Tebow's been, he wins football games. And it takes more than just a quarterback to win a football game. When you have every other offensive player giving more effort, when you have your defense, every player coming out to congratulate you when you come to the sidelines, giving more effort, you have special teams, you have a team that's killing themselves for this kid, trying to prove everyone wrong. And I agree with Teddy Bruschi. Maybe you can't win championships playing this style of football, but you sure as hell can win football games. Miami Dolphins proved it when they beat the New England Patriots with that Wildcat because they've never seen it. And now you're going to tell me, you know, not you, but people say, oh, well, there's more tape on Tebow. People are more prepared now. North Turner. He's not going against Dick LeBeau. He's going against North Turner. What's Turner going to be prepared now for this? He's going to come up with the game plan to stop him, even though Rex Ryan couldn't do it? I don't see it. Tell me why I'm wrong. Why this isn't a gift taking Denver.
You had San Diego, you bet a futures bet on them?
Yeah, before the season. With the reasoning, not that I'm going to cash that ticket. I'm going, I think, for 5 Super Bowl futures in a row. Pick the winner. And this one, I thought they'd have such a good regular season, they'd win the division.
Get a bye.
And I'd be able to earn money off it because I was getting something like 15-1.
Yeah.
So I thought I'd be able to earn off the ticket. I didn't think they'd cash it. The Saints won, I thought I'd cash. And I thought I'd have better chances if the Steelers won cashing because I don't trust this team in the playoffs even if they got there.
Right. Well, my point being was that's probably the most expensive toilet paper that you've ever bought in your life.
Yeah, I don't even have the ticket no more. I'll be honest with you.
You threw it away already?
I can't find it right now.
I don't think you need to look for it.
Exactly.
You know how I feel about San Diego. I used Chicago as my best bet video last week against San Diego, and everything I said proved out. Chargers have lost 5 straight up and against the spread, losing the spread by a combined 35 points. They got Monday Night Football coming up. Now, granted, this is a divisional rival, and they've lost 5 straight games, but they've beaten Denver the last 4 times they played them by a combined 60 points.
So the already motivation, this year on the road, they beat them.
So the motivation there is more for Denver. And you made a key point. And if you watch, and I don't watch a ton of football. I do more of my work with box scores and power ratings. But just watching the players, the way they react to this guy. Anybody who's going to put their helmet down and run over defensive backs, linebackers, these players love that. They're physical people. When your quarterback will do that for you, it makes everybody else want to do that for you. And what I found pretty interesting, the last 2 weeks, Denver beat the Jets and the Chiefs. Over the last 5 weeks, San Diego played the Jets and the Chiefs. They lost to those two teams.
Exactly. And all the talk, oh, who's Denver beating? They've caught this team off of that. They've caught this team off of that. They've caught this guy at the right time. This team with an injured player. They get everything but credit for being 4-1 with this kid.
And you got San Diego
lost to the same teams, like you just said.
Yeah, same teams. Denver's 3-2 straight up on the road this year, 4-1 against the spread on the road. We talked about this slightly at the meeting on Tuesday, and I said, I'm not so sure San Diego's the better team.
Exactly. And you said something else on the Tuesday meeting that made perfect sense, and I've been doing this a lot. You said it last week. You said it again this week. Without the names, look at the stats for both teams.
Right.
And you tell me whether the number should be 7 based on not knowing who the teams are.
Yeah. It just amazes me how long people are going to continue to bet. And I've had this conversation with RJ, and he's not here, but he's talking about your preseason power ratings compared, and I talk about how you make your adjustments as the year goes on. These people that came into the season, and you bet San Diego in the future. People are looking at that number one offense, number one defense last year, supposed to clean up the special teams. It hasn't happened. You've got to change your power ratings. If you continue to bet against San Francisco, against Cincinnati, even Buffalo until lately, they've started to play more to what we expected. But San Diego, you go broke.
The odds makers refuse. They have an ego when they put out those numbers, and they refuse to show they're wrong. When you look and they had a team ranked 6th, and now they should be closer to 16, making that drop, it's an ego thing. And like Alf said at the Tuesday meeting also, let all the sharps, all the wannabe sharps, keep betting these bad teams thinking they're going to make money, and you could just keep cleaning up on the better teams, like the San Franciscos, like you said.
Yeah. You take a look at San Diego. Everybody keeps waiting. This is the week. This is the week. It's the same guys who are waiting on, this is the week San Francisco is going to fail. I mean, after a while, you got to realize these teams change. I mean, this is sports. And it's a camaraderie type of thing. How many times have we seen in baseball, the Minnesota Twins, the Atlanta Braves that 1 year, they go to the World Series, worst to first.
Yeah.
I mean, the St. Louis Rams. I knew a guy when the Rams won the Super Bowl, he got the Rams at 200-1 to win the Super Bowl before the season because the Rams weren't any good. But he watched some of the preseason games, and he liked the way Mike Martz has taken over this offense. And he said, I think there's some value there. And they win the Super Bowl. So there are teams that go from worst to first, and this is the Denver team. Not only are they going from the worst to first type of thing, but coming into the season, nobody liked Denver. Once they put Tebow in there,
they especially disliked
Denver. Denver's continuing to win, and teams that have that ability to win, and you're catching them in this point spread, especially against San Diego. How many years has San Diego had the better talent and not won?
Not done nothing with it.
And this year, they don't have that second half thing where they turn it around like they have the last few years. Can you imagine being a player on San Diego's team right now? Even though you know this is a divisional game and you need this game, you just can't turn it on like that.
If they'd be able to turn it on, they'd have done it a while before.
Right.
You know, they're not just going to do it right now against Denver.
Yeah.
I just think there's too much value. I made my true line 4.5.
Makes a lot more sense.
With the bias towards Denver, and I think there's about a 2-point negative bias towards them almost with the Tebow. I've made the book line 6.5, and that's where it is, 6.5, 7. So I'm not surprised that's where the line is. That's where it should be to try to get balanced money. But the true line is where you're going to get value.
Right.
And my true line reflects this one should be closer to 4, 4.5 than where it is now. And to me, that's a ton of value. And the reason the books have no drive to adjust the number is because who's cashing tickets with Denver? They could go on and cover the next 4 games, and nobody wants to bet Tebow.
Right.
Because all week, all day, all you hear is how bad of a football player he is as a quarterback. How, he's not the future. Bottom line, This kid's winning football games. This team, forget the kid, the team's winning football games right now. It's the Denver Broncos. Even though my notes say Tebow, I'm betting on Denver. I'm not betting on Tim Tebow. I'm not prop betting that he throws for 300 yards. I'm just betting at plus seven, I'm getting the value.
Yep, I agree.
This is my best bet. Got a big weekend plan. Had a perfect 6-0 week in college football last week. I love the holidays because there's always extra value with all the bettors coming in looking for action. Big card in NFL as well. Want to wish you all a great Thanksgiving. Great holiday. Be safe out there if you go out tonight. Enjoy the games. Don't forget pregamevideos.com. We'll be jumping in and out, posting our notes, answering questions and comments. Guys, have a great Thanksgiving. Enjoy the games. Cash some tickets.